The last section we'll talk about for our sinus rhythms is a sinus arrest or a sinus pause. And a sinus arrest or sinus pause basically means that the SA note has failed to fire for one or more beats. Now, this is going to make the underlying rhythm a little bit slower and it's going to make it irregular. But what you have to remember with the sinus arrest or the sinus pause is it's not like our sinus arrhythmia where something is speeding up and slowing down. With this, the sinus note is just failing to fire for one or more beats. So we want to look at what was our rate before they went into the sinus pause, or what is our rate after they come out of the sinus pause? Because this is sinus arrest or sinus pause is telling me that the sinus note has failed to fire for a few beats. It does not tell me what the underlying rhythm is. So when I look at this strip here, I see that I have R to R to R to R, looks regular. This one here started to slow down just a little bit, and then it looks like I'm actually missing one or two beats here. And then it picks right back up, and my R to R to R becomes regular again. Now, granted, this particular pause is going to make my rhythm a little slower than what it should be. But what you want to do is you want to look at what was your rate before you went into this. And my rate before I went into it, I can tell, I mean, even just from this 6 seconds right here where I'm even missing some, I would have had at least a rate of 80, if not higher. So I would actually look at this as a sinus rhythm with a sinus pause. Now, I know this is sinus in origin because I have my sinus P wave, and my sinus P wave looks the same and symmetrical across my strip. And now I'm missing at least one or two beats here. Now, when I look at this, I want to look, when I'm trying to figure out how long of a pause I have, I go from the R before the pause and the R after the pause, and I count how many large boxes of time I have in there. And my boxes of time, it looks like I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and my lines are really hard for me to see here, but it looks like seven large boxes, and each box is 0.2 seconds of time. So that would basically be 1.4 second pause. So when we go to this next strip here, this next one that we see here, again, if this is all I counted as my 6 second strip, I would say I had a sinus bradycardia. But actually what I have here, if I had seen a longer strip of time, is I could have seen that my rate here looks like it's probably more a rate of 60, and then it looks like I'm missing a couple beats. So I have a what looks like a regular rhythm from here to here, and from here to here, I am just missing a couple beats in between here. My P wave looks the same and round and symmetrical across my strip. And my PR interval looks like the measurement is good. My QRS measurement looks good. And my QT interval looks like it's okay. It actually looks like it might be a little long. But other than that, it looks like it's fine. So when I'm trying to see how long of a pause I would have, I would count how many large boxes I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Looks like a little over 17. And again, each large box is 0.2 seconds of time. So that would be about a 3.5 second pause. And since it's a little over, we'd probably call it a 3.6 second pause. So this person would probably be a little bit more compromised with this than our person who only had our little 1.7 second pause. But I can still tell this is sinus in origin. My R to R to R looks regular. My sinus P wave is there. All my interval measurements are okay. I am just missing a couple beats here. Now, this one right here, it looks like I have a regular rhythm from QRS to QRS and QRS to, oops, sorry about that. And then QRS to the next QRS, it looks like I'm regularly spaced, and then I'm missing some beats. And then it looks like I would have picked right back up. Again, if I look at this, I would just say, okay, I have a sinus brady at 40. But that's really not what you have. If you had seen that longer strip, and usually when someone has a pause, your machine runs you out a much longer strip, you would have seen R to R to R to R being regular until you got to those beats that were missing. So here I have what looks like probably a rate of 60, because this prior right here would have been a 3 second strip, so a rate of 60. And I have this time lag here. And if I wanted to find out how long, I would count how many large boxes, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, so almost 16, so about a 3.2 second pause. So instead of saying I have a sinus pause, that's only telling me that I have a gap in my rhythm. I need to look at the underlying rhythm. I have a sinus rhythm at 60 with a sinus pause. Now, these pauses can be caused by hypoxia. They can be caused by DIG toxicity. So if you have a patient who's on digoxin, we should definitely be getting a DIG level. Vagal stimulation. So if this is the first time this cardiac patient has gotten up to the bathroom and they're constipated and they're bearing down really hard, we might get this type of pause, or just someone who's starting to have damage to the SA node. The significance, of course, is going to depend on how long the pause is and how the patient's tolerating it and how frequently they're having them. One person might have a pause where they bear down, they have a 3-second pause, it goes away, and they never have another one, and they feel fine. Other people may be having these every few seconds, they're having a pause, they're having them frequently, and they're starting to become compromised with it. So if we would expect any symptomology, it would be similar to that of a bradycardia. We would see dizziness, lightheadedness, drop in blood pressure, maybe some chest pain or shortness of breath, and we would treat it like that bradycardia. We would speed this up by giving atropine, usually as the drug of choice, 0.5 milligrams IV push. And that will end our section on sinus pauses. Thank you.